We're spraying, as I said, 42,000 houses at this stage. We're just over the halfway mark, hoping to finish the IRS, or the indoor residual spraying, on the 25th of April, which is quite a significant date in our calendar because it's the International Malaria Day. We recruit the spray operators from the communities because they have to enter people's houses. So we find that if we recruit people from the area, at least they're known to the house owners. They spray basically 6 days a week. They start at 6 in the morning and finish at 2 in the afternoon due to the heat. So we're trying to do as much work as possible before we hit the real Mozambican humidity and heat in the day. There's a lot of training that goes into it because the application method and technique is really important to reach the efficacy. So they trained over a 10-day period how to not only mix and apply the insecticide, but how to wear the applicable PPE, because we need to protect them while they're doing the work.
We're about to spray now, we're about to actually get our hands dirty and actually see, we've seen how it gets done, and now it's our turn.
So the way you carry it is you carry it with, this thing
you carry from here?
Front.
From here, yeah.
You carry it on your shoulder like that?
Oh, like that. Yeah.
On the left one.
On the left one, yeah. Sorry.
On the left one, yeah.
There we go, alright. Just watch if you don't press that before you spray. Hey, man. Good spray, man.
Yes. And then if you change swipe, you need to do like a mini cut pass for your right.
For right side.
You change swipe.
Yes.
And then you come up.
Now for the kids.
Yeah.
Estou a fazer muito rápido.
Não, tá bom.
Tá bom.
Yeah. Yeah. And hold you. Hold you. Yeah. Now you go. Come on. How many steps? Right place.
Yeah, right place.
I'm shorty.
Up there. But it's different to do it outside and inside.
Inside.
And wearing that clothes. That clothes is very hot.
Yeah.
Hot. Everything is
I think it's, the nice thing about this is you're making a difference in normal people's lives, as you can see. I mean, this is a rural community. Sometimes it feels as if they're almost the forgotten ones. So they're the ones that's benefiting out of this, and it's just a nice feel-good story.
Ouvi dizer tantas coisas, festas, nananani. Nananana, nananana, Maria, nananeira, nananana.